Python on Hardware News.
It's Blinka time. All the latest in Python on hardware coming to you in your mailbox.
Yeah.
And also here.
All right. So
okay.
This week, let me go back here. I think I made a mistake with...
we have so many exciting newsletters. There's a lot. All right. Number one, we are sponsoring PyCon US 2021. We sponsor every year, but we're also sponsoring this year.
Yeah.
It's online. Go register. We also support the Python Software Foundation. Thanks, PyCon. They've been awesome. I can't wait to get back to visiting PyCon in person and doing hardware giveaways and stuff. We also had Moo 1.0 Beta 4 come out. We really want people to try it out. Please download the latest version of Moo because we've updated how CircuitPython boards are detected, and it's good. It means more boards will be detected, even if they're not from Adafruit. So, like, any CircuitPython board should probably show up now. We have 200 boards. I don't know if you knew, Phil. We have 200 boards in CircuitPython.
More than 200 now.
More than 200. Making sure they all have the VIDs and PIDs. It turned into BMS. So we did another way.
All right. So deep dives, as usual, with Scott. You can check out the recaps there, a little bit of information, and also a link to the video. Subscribe if you want. Here's an animation demonstrating Adafruit Circuit Playground Express. This is kind of a neat thing. It's a little remote shutter. This is kind of cool. The Pico Touch PCB is designed to work with Raspberry Pi and Pico and CircuitPython. Tabot, working on those. They look really good.
That's cool. Nice silkscreen there.
Yep.
More keyboards.
This is the Gherkin PCB built specifically for the Raspberry Pi Pico running CircuitPython from 40% keyboards. By the way, that is one of the best sites. And here's the thing. If you know the person at 40% keyboards, tell them two things. Number one, good job not having any way to contact you at all whatsoever.
They did such a good job hiding from the internet.
Usually find anyone, and I'm just wow.
This person is gone, which means they don't want to be contacted.
Yeah, because I wanted to say, hey, good job, good work, but there's no way to get a hold of them. So anyways, no way to comment, no way to do anything. So good work.
Here's more keyboards.
We have a really neat, Paintinator. This is a pen plotter for folks with particular disabilities using CircuitPython.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. Here's a mouse shake, your Raspberry Pi, a Neo Trinky project. Mm. Here is a very, 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 very cool display that uses CircuitPython that goes to the Marvel API and pulls out the character and the issue stuff, which is really neat.
Yeah, I know they had an API. They have a big API.
Yeah, and it's based on the tech from Black Panther, which is really cool. Little cute feather bot. You can use CircuitPython with it. And a
whole bunch more keyboards, mag tags.
Special thanks to Katni, who is running a newsletter, why Anne was out. Anne's back. And so you'll see the newsletter. No one noticed the differences between different authors. We just had a bunch of stuff and a good pipeline of news. So that is this week's Python on Hardware.
Yay, Blinka!